A Filipino cruise ship employee is handed 30 years in prison for planting hidden cameras inside passenger staterooms to record underage girls. Don Tagala has the details.
A federal judge in Florida has sentenced a Filipino cruise ship employee to 30 years in federal prison for planting multiple hidden cameras in guest rooms he used to work at to record videos of naked girls. 34-year-old Arvin Joseph Mirasol of Batangas, a stateroom attendant who serviced passenger cabins, had pleaded guilty to serially recording videos of young girls as soon as he started working on the Symphony of the Seas in December of 2023. Court documents stated that investigators found these pornographic videos saved in a USB stick owned by Mirasol, containing some videos of naked females in cruise ship bathrooms, as well as videos of child pornography. Investigators said that the focus of the videos was on the children's genital areas, and Homeland Security investigation agents identified children in the videos with ages ranging from 2 to 17 years old. The former cruise ship worker also admitted to investigators that he placed cameras in the rooms of guests that he likes, usually teenage girls. He also admitted that he's aware that what he was doing was illegal, but that he would still enter the guests' rooms and hide under their beds while recording them naked with his cellular device. Mirasol has been recommended to be locked up in a facility that provides psychological counseling and sex offender treatment. A U.S. government inmate finder shows Mirasol is currently imprisoned at the Federal Detention Center in Miami, Florida. Mirasol's counsel has filed an appeal on his behalf. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News.
In South America, the worst drought on record has brought the Amazon basin's water levels to historic lows. Water levels in the Solimo West, a main tributary of the Amazon, has fallen to its lowest level ever at 4.25 meters below average. Meanwhile, nearby Lake Tefe has also dried up, depriving freshwater dolphins of their habitat. This is the second consecutive year of critical drought that has parched much of Brazil's vegetation and triggered wildfires across South American countries. The camp of Alice Go insisting that senators did not have concrete proof to back their claims about the dismissed town mayor. Questions about Go's alleged romantic relationship with Sual Mayor Liseldo Calugay and allegations of money laundering were raised during the Senate's Tuesday hearing. But Go's lawyer, attorney Stephen David, believes senators don't have evidence to implicate his client.
Tinatanong nga siya, saan galing to? Sino to? Saan ginamit to? Hindi nga nila alam eh. Full generalization yun eh. Tapos kukuhaanin mo yung detail sa tao. Kukuhaanin mo yung detalya kay Alice. Hindi kung talagang solid yung evidence, labas mo na lang.
David also says they plan to post bail for the graft charges against Go once the Senate hearings end. This so Go can evade the Senate's standing arrest order against her. The ex-mayor is currently in the custody of the police for two counts of graft that were filed when she was deported from Indonesia.
Sa ngayon kasi, pag nag-post ka ng bill, nakakulo pa rin naman siya eh. Diba? And worse, sabihin nila sa'yo, dadali ka sa Correctional Institute for Women kahit hindi ka convicted, di ba? Most likely, kung tapos na yung kanya detention sa Senate, most likely, pupos siya ng bail para makalabas siya.
The head of the Presidential Task Force on Media Security confirms the effective immediate expiration of his term. Undersecretary Paul Gutierrez served as executive director for over a year. Gutierrez says President Marcos's commitment to the task force sends a clear message that he is dedicated to creating a safe media environment for every member of the press. The Presidential Communications Office says Marcos has yet to appoint a replacement for Gutierrez.